Hi, Guido Fox here. Welcome by a new book report. And today I want to talk about Osho. And he wrote a book about yoga, the mystery of the soul. Nearly 250 pages of spiritual knowledge. Very interesting. If you think about yoga, you think about all those kind of exercises you do on a yoga mat. And if you think about Tantra, you also think about a little bit different positions with sexuality and movements in your body, that everything is flowing and that kind of stuff. But he's talking about another form of yoga, the mystery beyond mind. And actually, he's talking here about spiritual evolution, spiritual growth, and raising up your calibration levels. And if you look to Tantra, I also make a book report about that. And yoga, that's actually in pre-stage for going higher in spiritual evolution, because your body must be flexible, your body must be chill and relaxed. And from chillness and relaxing attitude towards your body, you create also chillness and relaxing towards your life, and you become relaxed. And from relaxed, the flower in yourself is able to grow, the seed is able to grow to a flower in your body. So the seed you can feel in your chest, 2 centimeters on the right, your hijrada opening. That's the first opening, your spiritual opening. And then you can be growing higher and higher to upwards streams in your head, in your crown. And then you can reach higher spiritual levels of calibration levels. So when he talked about yoga and when he talked about Tantra, Osho was talking about Tantra and yoga in ultima forma, so in the highest form of yoga. And the highest form of Tantra is, of course, enlightened sex or enlightened yoga, when you are completely aware about your body and also about your inner body and about your inner line, about your inner chakras, about your crown chakra, about the ecstatic feelings in your body. That is yoga in optima forma. So when he's talking about the mystery beyond mind and yoga, he's talking about that and not about the simple yoga exercising, the stretching, stretching on the yoga mat. Yoga means, he's talking about that in his introduction, yoga means unio mystica. Yoga is unio mystica. Unia mystica means, of course, wholeness, oneness with yourself. So bridging with yourself. So yoga means also enlightened. Yoga is enlightened. Yoga is also from yogis. Yogis who are following yoga. Yogis are also people who wants to become enlightened, who are striving to that path. And what you see is also the unio mystica. It means oneness, wholeness. Is unio is wholeness in mysticus, mystica, occultism. So you want to become whole, your inner line related to your mind, mind turning inwards. That's the whole purpose of yoga. And that is also yoga itself. So that's the important thing about yoga. The second point I want to discuss with you is where you come from. We all had to go to school. Yes, so that's our past, that's our history. A lot of people were not happy in schools, or they try to do that they are happy in school, so they have a smiling face, but behind there are a lot of fierce anger for the teacher or for the friends, your surroundings, group pressure. A lot of people learned not a lot in the schools. They were not getting the right incentives to fluorate to become higher in their capacity. So under learning. So a lot of people were not happy in the schools, and it's also what Osho see. But also the school rooms, and that's very interesting. You all the school rooms, I think from the lower school from in the Netherlands, class 3, I think class 1 and 2 are very nice. You can play with blocks, you can play with the Poppenhoek, you can play with paintings, play music. So the school rooms in class 1 and through and partly 3 were very nice. But after that, if you recognize it and be aware of it, I must not be aware of it, but I read Osho, and Osho's awareness was very high, then the school rooms become very ugly. And that's very interesting. They become ugly because the only thing you can concentrate is the board, is the teacher and the things he was writing down. And there it's going wrong in our mental health, because in group 1 and 2 you're doing paintings of the lower school and you play, so your creative impulses are very good. And then you step over from the creativity to the thinking process, and then you learn to concentrate, and concentrate to strive, and concentrate to reach something, and concentrate to pick up all the knowledge and the focus for society. So the school systems and the school rooms are designed to concentrate. And Osho was saying, okay, you will be prepared for a job in society, and where you have to concentrate, and that leads to an unnatural form of yourself. So in class 1 and 2, you are yourself, you are natural, you are playing with things, you are painting, you are playing music, you are dancing, you're playing with blocks, you're building a castle or whatever. So you're creating, and that's your natural self. And then society is killing that creativity in your consciousness, and there it goes wrong. And therefore, a lot of people are bored in their jobs and not finding the right life path, because creativity is killed. And where creativity is killed, flowering is killed, and how your mood is killed, and your happiness is killed. So that's all the stories from the ugly school rooms. And thereafter, concentration leads not to higher spiritual levels. It is contemplation and meditation what leads to higher spiritual forms of evolution. So concentration is focus, and you also manage, if you concentrate on an object or a thing, then you will be empty also soon. So concentration leads to an empty battery very quickly and very soon. And if you go from concentration to contemplation or meditation, there's a completely different relaxing mood where everything is flowing, and you can stay teaching, you can stay talking, you can give seminars away from 2, 3 hours, and you can talk and you can talk because you're going from another energy source. So your source of energy will be different than what you learned from your lower school, middle school, and your university years. So all those 18 to 20 years into school systems is conditioned your mind into concentration and focus, and you can't hold that all your day. So all your day, your concentration, you get a burnout. And that's what you see in daily life, in business life, that people can burn out because they have to concentrate all the time. And that's not possible. If you're going into meditation, into contemplation, you're doing your things from another source, from another energy source. You're doing it from Godliness. You're doing it from the Amrita Nadi line in your body. You do it from ecstaticness. There's a total different quality of your mind. You're going from focus. You're going from the conflict, striving phase to the more contemplative phase. You go from focus, striving, fighting, fight and flight phase in your life. You're going from focus to focus to a phase where everything is flowing and where you operate from a relaxing, chill source. And that source is totally different than what you learned in those 18 to 20 years in the school systems where you were. So be aware of that, that there are other forms of frustrating, focusing on a topic than what you're now doing in your life. So more contemplative phase, more meditative state, and you can reach a higher quality of work, I think, and you can also have a higher quality of energy in your body, so you can prolong your projects, but also you can do your work from a better quality, because if you're focused, you focus, that is a short-term operation, but also if you're focused, then easily you forget what is happening on table B, or in C, or in subject Z. So you focus on A and you forget B. And when you are creating a higher form of awareness, you create a higher form of consciousness, you create rounded awareness, and you're more aware of what's happening by other projects, and you can see more the whole picture from what are you doing actually on this way. So that's all the knowledge from me to you about the ugly school atmosphere and the school's building, but also the lessons where you had your teachings. That is very important to understand. So deconditioning from that ugly conditioned way from the school rooms. I want to go to the third point, and that is drop your personalities for spiritual growth. We all know that we act different in different situations. And the people who are very different in different groups are mostly related to ego positionalities. So I know some people who are very different in business life than in real life. They are drinking, they are drunk, they are shouting, they are dancing in clubs, they're aggressive in the weekend, but they're very nice and polite when they are working during the days by their business. So you see people a lot of masks. And what Osho is saying here on page 67 is drop your mask, be real. Be natural. That is more healthy and less energy consuming than be constantly another guy or another girl, or you change your mask constantly and you don't know who you are. So be more natural, be more real, and drop your mask, your so-called civilized mask, masks off. Show yourself, show your real self, be natural. That's less energy consuming, and above all that, it makes you also very happy if you show your real self to people. Of course, if your real self is always very angry and very violent, I should go for a coach to change that, to become more aware, and to go higher in your consciousness. But the main topic here is be yourself, be natural, and drop all those so-called civilized personalities off. So all those 10 different forms you are in different groups, kill that. And I remembered also in my past that I was a different guy on the football training than in the school, and I was different in my work, and I was different home and by my family. But now I'm everywhere quite the same, and quite the same, and always in contact with my inner line, and always be aware, and always try to reach the higher form of consciousness. So I am the same. I'm the same everywhere. I'm more natural everywhere. I'm not ashamed that I'm not be someone else in a kind of group. I'm the same. I'm natural, and I don't change if I am in another group. Of course, I'm coming new in a group. I look around and see, okay, what's this group dynamic? Don't be the biggest shouter the first second or the first minute. So look around a little bit, but be yourself. That's less energy consuming, and also you become very happy if you not have to be aware constantly what kind of role you want to play in this group. So drop your roles, drop your mask. That is very important here for subject 3, for point 3 from Osho, Yoga, the Science of the Soul, after the ugly schoolrooms and the Unio Mystica. I want to discuss with you the last topic. And the last topic here is God is vastness. And on page 20. Nearly the last pages in his book, he is writing that God is vastness. And I want to discuss with you vastness. And the only thing I can say is that God is Godliness. God is the inner line in your body. And if you can reach that vastness, if you can hold the line, I always talk to myself, hold the line, hold the line, hold the line. If you can hold the line in yourself, then you create a massive power, a massive attraction field, a massive peace line in yourself. And that is God. That is vastness. So they always also say nothingness, emptiness, but Godliness is also vastness. So it is also always vastness and Godliness and nothingness and emptiness in one. So the line is empty and the line is vast. So it's really paradoxical here, right? So vastness and emptiness. So your nothingness is also your emptiness. Your line is also vast, but also flexible. And all those paradoxes is always a sign that you are in a spiritual world, because the spiritual world is full of paradoxes to make you more flexible, flowing water, and not rigid and rock, as the rigid personalities of changing constantly your mask. Then you become rigid in different forms. You're 10 times rigid. You choose that mask and that mask and that mask. And now you're natural, you're whole, you're flowing, and you have one beautiful mask. But you're flowing inside. You are like a river, but your mask is vastness. So all those paradoxes makes also this spiritual world very mystical and intrusive. I want to thank you for watching this short book report about yoga, about ugly schoolrooms, and deep drop your personalities, your mask, and about vastness of your Amrita Nadi line, of your inner chakra line. Very thank you for watching, and I see you the next book report about spiritual growth. Hi.